Right, hi guys, we're back for a bit more GTA. So, yeah, it's been a while again. It's been about a week, I think. 10th of May, and today's the 16th. So, what I'm gonna do today is I'm just gonna try and get 10 more tags actually. I'm just gonna drive around a bit randomly rather than do any missions. Still feeling a bit stressed. It feels like it's just been a bad week in general. I've just been feeling a bit flat. I mean, the weather's not helped. The government regulations haven't helped. I've been going nowhere though, so none of that really matters. Right, so got my spray can, and we've got 70 tags at the moment. So I'm gonna try and find the remain. Well, I'm gonna try and find 10 more. Now I remember last time I played, there was one in a kind of. Oh, I can see one there, which I've not got. Yeah, there was one up some stairs, so I can vaguely remember where that one was. So there we go. Right, 9 more to go then. So there might be some around here. I've not seen any. And I have a feeling there's some kind of just, these kind of back alley houses. So I might just have a bit of a crawl around here, but also I wouldn't mind getting a car and just doing some cruising. I'll probably do a mission in a bit, but yeah, for now I just kind of felt like, a bit of just downtime really. I was already kind of thinking this morning, oh, I've got all these bits and bobs I need to do, all these little tasks. And yeah, my stepdad delivered some bits and bobs so I can carry on with my painting yesterday. We had a whole dance of trying to maintain social distancing while he dropped that off. So I've got some more paint, which means that I can crack on with more of that. She got this. This song is so appropriate for how I'm feeling at the moment. Just stressed. So yeah, let's just have a little ride. Yeah, I just felt like losing myself a bit in the game, so. Why not this one? Seeing as I've got to get to 100%. Well, that's not gonna happen. I'm just like, he's not happy. Right, so where could these remaining 19 be? Oh yeah, so there's that. That one I've seen, so I should probably go and get that. But yeah, I'll just have a little look around here, see if I can find anything. I've got so much trouble in my mind. Yeah, I mean, again, it's been, a good week, Done my bits and bobs, done my radio, done my live page entries. It's just all very. It doesn't feel very reassuring at the moment that people are going back to work. Without any kind of measure in place to stop this virus re-emerging, that's deeply concerning to me. I mean, yeah, we can all wear masks. Unfortunately, I've got some. And wash our hands, use hand sanitizer, all that stuff. Because I've been covering this, looking at the China side of it months before we were even thinking about it here. I was kind of ahead of the game in terms of thinking what I've got to do. That's one. But at the same time, being ahead sometimes isn't a good thing because you can kind of anticipate the bad things that are going to happen. So it's just too much thinking, really. A lot of thinking is always quite stressful. Ah, I can see one there. So this is good. I've managed to find some just by chance, which is good. But I mean, there aren't any kind of obvious ones in my mind now that I can just think, oh, I've got to find one there, I've got to find one there. So this is basically just what I've got to do, just hope that they appear. Now, you're probably noticing as well that I'm not coughing my guts up today. And I do generally feel okay. I've not... Maybe... Oh, I don't know. Could be the weather, but... I don't know. Comes and goes, this cough. But generally today, I don't feel... Don't feel bad. I'm going to have an imminent coughing fit. And when I say bad, obviously I don't mean coronavirus bad, I just mean asthma, hay fever bad. Tis the season. So, where else could they be? Let's go and find that one that I know about. Well, first, there's a load of ballers here and I want to... Okay, that's not where I thought I was going to end up, but I'll have a little meander around here anyway. I think I've got the one that's here, if there is one here. Might be making that up. Can't see anything. Yeah. I do wonder if just, you know, the stress has knocked the cough out of me at the moment, because... I do just feel more stressed than usual. I mean, all these remaining ones now, I'm sure they're going to be down some random little back alleyway. Now, it was around here, wasn't it? I think. Was it? Can't see anything. Look down here. Well, I'm pretty sure it's up there, so I might have another look. I don't know if I'm going back exactly the way I've been now. I think I am actually. I think I'm just literally repeating where I was. Not sure. Yeah, I came along this road. So I'm gonna have to get out of the car and have a look. Of course, this could just be something that looks like something else, so I don't know. I'm sure I saw one like
chaos comes order, out of pain comes love. A heavy storm means God hates you. Also, you can't smoke out in the rain.
I'm literally just going around in circles here. I killed a gas station attendant, but he deserved it. I'll just have a look here.
You think you're American, but do you drink American?
Lager, the beer that brought the forest down. I like to relax after a hard day at work, and I like to relax hard, get really drunk, so drunk you can't tell your sister from your wife.
What the fuck's now name that's you fun, doing?
And now I can do it without gaining pounds, thanks to New Lager Light. Drink even more, gain
right,
less.
I'm gonna it's get out and have a look. Just walk around and see if I can see anything. Oh dear, I'm a little bit snuffly. But yeah, I'm not coughing. But yeah, it's so annoying, this cough. You know, I keep trying to isolate why I might be, you know, coughing more times than others. You know, whether it's because there's more moisture in the air or less. Who knows? Ah, there we are. There it is. Excellent. Right, 74. Okay, so 6 more to get. And I have absolutely no idea where I'm going to go to look for them. So we'll get a car. What I might do is head up towards the kind of... So it's at the Mexican part of town. It's not. No, it's like. Who are they? The gang with this. Basically, around this kind of area. Welcome to the jungle. Right. So this kind of edge of town area. Oh, don't want to get, like, don't like shoot at me though, so I've got to be careful around here. Well, just anywhere where there's a gang. Ah, there's one. Oops. 75, right, 5 more to go. I was hoping today to do a bit of gardening because it's going to be warm, but it's just not very sunny, which is kind of also why I was like, oh, sod it, I'll just play some GTA for a bit because it just feels a bit ugh. But it says it's warm, it says it's about 15 degrees, but actually you can probably see I've got a jumper on because I just felt a bit cold. And just flat, so, oh, who knows at the moment. You know, you just got to take each day as it comes. Right. Not seeing anything. But I think that was good timing that I got those first 5, so... Because obviously I don't want to make you watch a really long video. But this is literally just guesswork, you know, could take me an hour to find one. So I'm just trying to think now logically based on where I've been, where I haven't been, where I might see some. I think I got one on that orange building. That was the first one I got. So maybe I'll try somewhere else. Maybe I'll head towards the beach. I think I've got that one, haven't I? In the here. Yeah. Right, get a car. Another car. I'll have a think. This one. I know where there might be one. Kind of, where is it? There's like some just random blocks up here, like blue blocks or something. And there might be some of those houses there. But around here, so I've already got this one, haven't I? The Golden Palms one, the one that's just tucked behind this building. Yeah, I have there. I've got that one. But there might be some. Where is it? There's like a. God, am I making it up? Yeah, behind. Is it here? I feel like, yeah, there's just like random blocks. Doesn't look like anything. I'll just have a quick look. Yeah, so, you know, it's been funny this week because, you know, actually I was saying to my parents yesterday, I've never really been involved in or interested in really in British politics. Aha, there we go. So 4 more. I mean, you know, I cover China, which has got very exciting politics. But also, you know, given what I do, I always have to remain impartial. So, you know, I don't talk about my views. But during a pandemic, where there are serious questions about the actions of what the government's doing that could impact people's health, it's a difficult line to meet. Ah, there we are, there's another one. Oh, but I've got the police after me, so I better get it quickly. Three more to get.
Hope you're enjoying San Andreas the right way. By forgetting how to read and thinking about wife swapping.
But it's not even so much, you know, what the government's actions are, because we don't actually know what they are. It's all very, very confusing on a day-to-day basis. And generally, I've just got so annoyed with people in suits. So it's more a cultural, well, it's not even a cultural thing, it's more a culture of people in suits having an answer for everything and not actually just saying, I have no idea what this virus is, how it's going to affect people, you know, whether the actions we're making will work, etc. It's like a lot of people have become afraid to actually just say, to hold themselves to account over their actions. And you know, I've been back and listened to some of the radio interviews I've done in the early stages. And I don't know, I'd like to think that I would try to be as honest as possible. So, you know, I think there have been times where I've, well, I think just in general, I've gone on radio, you know, people have asked me questions about this virus. And I've been clear that I'm not a scientist. And I don't have the answers. And also sometimes, you know, in the very early stages when we didn't even know whether the coronavirus could pass from person to person, we didn't know anything about it. You know, I felt that was something I was being clear in saying, we don't know, you know, at all what this is, which is scary, but the reality. But now it feels like there's more and more kind of voices coming forward, and you know, they'll put on their smart suits and they'll say it with their chest, you know, they know that the actions they are taking are right, and heaven forbid if anybody challenges them. And that, you know, I think it's just very difficult to deal with something like that. And I've become quite a fan of Andrew Cuomo, the New York governor, because he feels very real to me. He feels very honest, and he just says what he thinks. And he doesn't know what this is. None of us do. You know, even, you know, I'm a specialist. In the early stages, you know, I was simply saying, and these newspapers are saying that it only affects elderly people, until it didn't. And then obviously I'm seeing, you know, I remember I was getting very, very stressed early on when I was hearing British newspapers say, oh, it only affects elderly people. And it was like, hello, you're 2 months behind. And, you know, we've seen that it doesn't, and that it can affect medical workers, people who are the epitome of hygiene and health. And stuff like that is very difficult to stay calm about, as much as I try. God. Right, anyway, let's try somewhere else, because I might go down there, because I know there's, I think I've got some of the ones that are down, you know, these kind of areas. But it's process of elimination, so let's have a look anyway. You know what you think? I think I've got this one. Yeah, I've got that one. But yeah, that was for me a very, very difficult time listening to, you know, the UK government saying we're 2 weeks behind Italy. It's like, yeah, you're 2 months. We're 2 months behind. Yeah, 2 weeks behind Italy. And it's like, yeah, you're also 2 months behind China. without any kind of rationale about, you know, lockdown measures or anything. This is when we were still hearing about herd immunity. Anyway, I'm playing GTA. I shouldn't be ranting about the government in GTA, kind of just like while I'm going around, you know, etc. But I think some people need to get better at holding their hands up and saying what they don't know instead of being a big man. Putting on your fancy suit and pretending you know and talking bollocks, basically. The ones that I haven't got are going to be really discreet areas now, I'm sure, not just like at the edge of a road. There's not one in the Vinewood sign, I'm pretty sure, but go and have a look anyway. I might just go up now. It's not where I thought I was going to end up.
I've said it before. All you need to get through this life is a little patience and a speedball.
As you said, get through this life with a bit of patience. If only the world, I mean, this is another thing like that I can't kind of grasp. Sorry, I'm just like ranting while playing GTA. But, you know, people absolutely losing their heads over 2 months in, you know, being able to stay at home. You will die. Like, smokers may look relaxed and like they're having fun. Should, in theory, be actually quite a nice thing to do. You know, spend time at home with your family. 2 months, you can do your work. You know, if you can do your work, that is. I mean, I'm talking about, you know, people I know who've been losing their heads over just, you know, working at home. And they have jobs. You know, there have been things like wars that have gone on for years. In China's case, decades. You've just got to, you know, this is nothing really. Just this bit of time being able to stay at home, but can't speak for everyone. I can just say that it's made me quite passionately heated listening to people moan and not realise how good they've got it. I mean, when I saw my stepdad yesterday, some of the things he was moaning about, it's like, you do realise that you've had people living with you for the last 2 months, whereas I'm on my own. That in itself should be quite nice. But, you know, we find our positives, and, you know, I think we all have bad days. I'm having a bad week. That's okay, you know, we all have them. You know, even the people who look like, you know, everything's happy, smiley, I'm sure they're having terrible days during all this. Hey, bike skills improved. Not much. But, oh well. Been there, haven't I? Right, oh, well, let's go on here. I know there's one on the overpass, but I think I've got it. Yeah, I have, it's there. So, where to go? Where to go, Kerry? Back here. Take a while as well because I've got about four more to get. Anyway, watch some good TV this week. Gogglebox, as always, is excellent. And if you haven't watched it, the Charlie Brooker antiviral wipe. Oh my god, that was funny. That was brilliant. I used to watch his screen wipe, you know, his various wipe shows while I was in China. You could get them on, how was I watching it at the time? I think they were just on YouTube. Well, we found a way, but they were brilliant and I got a lot of my expat friends into them. You know, people who are not British. And she just absolutely loved them, and obviously it's been about 5 years since he's done it. I mean, longer than that. I mean, I was in China 10 years ago. But watching that, would it have been Wednesday or Thursday? It was just absolutely hilarious. It was just brilliant. I just constantly getting caught off guard by just things he says. It's just absolutely hilarious. right. Oh god, I think my bike's gone. Is it down here? I'll have a look here.
To come out of West London, no questions asked, no quarter given. Turn it up, people.
I don't think there are any, but we'll have a look. Okay, so here's the area, guys. Here's the area. Oops. Now here I'll have to come back to it at some point to do the firefighter mission, and that is, I think, pretty easy. I'm remembering doing it before, so that'll be one of the next missions I think I do. I mean, that's an overall game mission rather than actual, you know, one that moves the story along, but it's got to be done. It is quite easy. You've just got to put out the fires. Well, not having much luck here now. We were doing well early on, which means that I need to move on. This gang, I think. Just around this neighbourhood. Just not seeing anything. Ah, there's one. God, that was just plain sight. 78, two more. Got that one, yeah. The safe house. Right, where else might I find one? fight skills improved again, but I don't think there are any here. There's a gun there though. No. Pretty sure there's not an EMT station. Oh my god, I'm stuck. Nada. Was one round here before, didn't I? Because this is where I saved. I remember a few days ago, and I think I was on foot, and I was kind of meandering around. Obviously, I could do faster on a bike, but it didn't look like
There's
it.
There's a gritty new show this season on Weasel, where the law is the drama, and the drama is the law.
What the hell is the law? Law?
I never chased at all. I was always overcompetitive and shallow. Disabled brother I pretend doesn't exist. I only married you because you've got great guns.
Anyway, what else have I been watching TV
catch it
wise?
Thursdays on Weasel before it catches you.
If you're planning on heading out to the beach this weekend, don't bother. It's really not that interesting. Sand,
yeah.
Sun,
as he said, if you're planning on heading out to the beach, do not bother.
Drink until you puke and act like a goddamn American. You're on the home of Driving Rock Radio.
No further comment. Right, so I'm on the edge of the construction zone. Are there any around here? I don't think there are. You know, this would be the obvious area because there's loads of open space. And I think I've only seen like one or two in this area, but I haven't seen any. And I can't remember any from when I originally did this. The last time I played this, which was a good year ago, maybe 2 years ago, I did try to do all the tags in one go. Like, I basically tried to, as soon as stuff was unlocked, try and find it. And I could only get up to 92 tags, so that's why I'm thinking, like, you know, do 10 at a time, but... Is there one there? There's not one there. I thought I saw one here. But, yeah, it's going to get extremely problematic. I mean, I remember, yeah, 92, and I couldn't find 8 of them. And this is just a limited part of the map open at this point. So, yeah. I think what I'll do is when I get to... So I'm planning to get to 80. I might try and do another... Well, 80 today, but I might try and do another kind of, you know, one of these episodes where I get to 90. But after that, I'll wait until way later when I get the jetpack. Yeah! And then I'll just hope, you know, I'll literally just go by air and see if I can spot those remaining 10. But they could be anywhere and I could be spending hours just looking for one. So it'll be part of the missions, I think, where I'll try and find them. Not seeing anything. Alright, have a think, Terry. Here, maybe?
It's going to rain today, so stay indoors and keep the dial jammed.
I did not get that one. 79. Right, one more to get them.
Beautiful day of San Andreas pollution for all you people to enjoy. On with the classic.
Don't drink and drive. So where is my final tag? Anything up there? No. Not anywhere. Can't get up there anyway. And I got the one in that corner, yeah. Chased with OG Loke, one of these guys down these little side ones. So I'm just exploring these, but see me. Let's have a look. Oh, visibility's gone now because it's raining. No, nothing here. That was a weird little... Yeah, you come out the top of a building. Ha ha! Excellent. 80. Brilliant. And... Oh, have I run out of spray paint now? I have. So... I'm just going to check here, because that would be really annoying if there's... Because I know there's one where it literally looks opposite another one, but it's there. It's there. It's literally... Look. And I've run out of spray paint. That is so annoying. I'm never going to be able to find this area again either. So what I might have to do is... how do I do this? Map. And then you can like put a... There we go. Like that. We'll put a target on it so I can remember where that is. I do need to do that later on anyway, just, you know, to find stuff, because otherwise I'll never finish this game. It'll be impossible. Alright, so I'm going to go back to his original house where I can get the spray can, and then I'll save. I'm just wondering whether to go back for that, and then I've got it though. Ah, but I did say I only get to 80, so no, I'll save it. Right, I don't think I've got anything in there. Have I got things? Yeah, I've got things in the garage. What's in there? Car and bicycle, I'll leave that. Okay. So, 80 tags. Soon to be 81. There we go. Lots of paint. And we'll save. I should still be 9.09. It is, yeah. So, no progress. But, a lot of progress in terms of trying to get the tags. So, all good for now. And I'll see you soon.